Developing now, a scare at a Palm Beach County charter school sends parents rushing to their children's side. Police say a student armed with a glucometer pricked more than a dozen of her classmates, and now police are investigating how this happened. Angela Rozier is live at the charter school in Boynton Beach with more information. Angela?
Well, Tiffany, police tell us 20 students were nicked either in the neck or either on the face by this student. As a matter of fact, the students tell us it happened in the hallway, and some say it happened on the school bus. Right now, detectives are questioning a 13-year-old girl they think is responsible.
Boynton Beach police and paramedics were called to the charter schools of Boynton Beach at around 12:45 p.m. Parents rushed to the upper school campus as soon as they got the news.
Some girls started just poking guys with the needle. I guess he knows more than I do.
This woman says her son was poked on the neck.
Who did that to you? Some girl.
14-year-old Rodney Bazil says the same thing happened to him.
I told her it's not funny because wherever she got it from, people might have AIDS.
He says he was on the bus at the time.
He poked me right here. She got me off guard. I had my hands on his bus seat, and then I turned around and she poked me.
Police said the device, a glucose meter, looks similar to this one. It's used to measure blood sugar levels.
The needle is about an eighth of an inch, and I want to show you. This is one that fire rescue uses.
They say there were no major injuries. Several students were checked out by paramedics outside the school, and others were transported to a nearby hospital as a precautionary measure.
What we need to stress here is that we don't have any major injuries here. The issue at this point is the exposure to this glucometer. Where did the glucometer come from?
And police are also recommending that parents take their children to their family doctor if they need any follow-up care. They're also telling us that 13-year-old student who was responsible faces 20 counts of battery and culpable negligence charges, which are misdemeanor charges. Reporting live in Boynton Beach, Angela Rozier, WPBF 25.